what have been your impressions of this transition? You went from Borton last year to Stollings this season. How have you handled that?
I think personally I've handled it really well. It's something I did in high school, playing the run and gun offense. I love it. I think I can adjust to things pretty quickly, and I think our team has also done really well. I think we spent the whole summer being able to adjust to this, and now that practice started, that we've showed great improvement.
And how long did it take for you to adapt to this this faster paced style?
I think the hardest thing was just getting in shape for it. I'm able to run and play that style, but when you're tired, it's obviously hard to keep up with it. I think this summer was just the time to adjust to it and to continue getting better at it. And I think now we're all set on the style of play.
I guess how much have you thought about passing Whalen's mark, which is something you could do this season for most points? I mean, how much do you think about it? Do you have any thoughts of what it would mean to get that far? I guess what's your take on that milestone?
Yeah, it's a huge goal of mine. It's not something I think about all the time. I think it'll come as when I'm playing and if I continue to produce as I have these last 3 years. But it's a huge goal. I know about it. I see it in my future, and I think it's awesome, and I'm really excited. But it's not something I continue to think about on a daily basis. It's more I continue to think about my team and just getting better individually, and that's something that's going to come along.
And on that note, is for you, is there any extra significance knowing what Whalen did after her career here? She's won a couple titles, knowing that you'd be in that company?
Yeah. I mean, we're such different players, played with a totally different type of team, but she's incredible, and just anyone even relating me and her together is great, and that's one of like the nicest things I could ever hear, is being related to someone as great as her. So, yeah.
So the next step would be for joining her in the links, right?
Oh, I would love that. I'd be so happy.
So is this a secret ploy then?
Oh, my gosh.
Is this your calling card?
I hope. I hope so. Please.
You mentioned, though, trying to get everyone else better. What do you make of your new players that have come in? Kelly, who transferred,
yeah.
Carly Wagner from the freshman class. What do you make of all your new recruits?
They're great. Shay is incredible, athletic, fast. She's going to be hard to guard. So she's going to help us a lot, take a lot of pressure off from me and Amanda. Carly's a great shooter. She's in great shape. She knows how to play basketball. So they're helping us as much. And we have a bunch of players that have already been here that are going to help us a lot too.
And then just how do you think that's going to help spread things out? Because last year you and Amanda formed a great 1-2 tandem, but a lot of teams would kind of strategize for that.
Yeah.
It's going to be different this year with Shay and Carly and
yeah.
Your other.
I think it's just going to be so hard for them to figure out what defense to play. Usually me or Amanda would be double teamed, and they're not going to be able to do that this year because someone has to be on Shay, someone has to be on Carly. So I'm interested to see what defense they throw at us to figure out how to guard all of us.
And on that note, too, you go, I think, from 10 players, now you're up to 14. How do you think that
yeah.
extra depth is going to help? Because I think at the end of the season, you only had 7 players.
Yeah, there. Yeah, it's life-changing. I'm excited so that I'm not going to be constantly tired and, you know, not knowing that there's no one behind me to be able to sub me out. So knowing that we have 14 girls on the team, we have a bunch of people that can come in and be able to play.
And so, I guess, what have you learned about resiliency? These last 3 years, you've had some pretty good marks. You haven't made the NCAA tournament yet, and here you are, fourth year, and you're still here with Minnesota. What have you learned about just weathering through adversity?
Yeah, I think that's kind of been the biggest thing, is just getting over adversity for this team. I think that we've shown it a lot. I just think that we got to get better consistently and finishing out games, and that's what's going to get us to the NCAA tournament.
Yes, what impressions would you like to make individually or as a team or with this community for your final season in the Maroon and Gold?
Just leaving with impact of, you know, being able to go to the NCAA tournament and just showing everyone the type of leadership that I had on this team and being able to make this team one of the greatest teams that's been here and just leaving my individual mark and team mark.